guarded approach. The brothers found the skeleton in the woods, just lying in a pile of leaves beside the path. It was the best luck ever. They couldn't afford to buy Halloween decorations, and they really wanted to have something to hang on the door. It was a small animal of some sort, perfectly laid out. Odd, but they were too young and carefree to worry about that. They took it home, found some wire and an old hand drill in the shed, and set to work. It looked grand on the door. On Halloween night, they dressed in their ghost sheets, put on the spooky music, and waited for their friends to knock on the door. It was their turn to host the party, and they couldn't wait. But no one did knock, and neither of them had any credit on their mobiles to ring around, or the desire to check their social media. Instead, they stuffed themselves on cheap candy and bemoaned their unpopularity. The next morning, the skeleton had gone. They thought it was odd again, but shrugged at each other and went to school. When they got there, all their friends were huddled around and talking in excited, whispered chatter. It stopped when one of the gang spotted them.
"Where did you get it?"
she asked.
"Get what?"
they said in unison.
"That blooming monster you put on guard duty outside your door. Johnny said it was animatronics, but it looked bloody real to me."
The brothers looked at each other aghast. They were so annoyed that they'd missed all the fun.